Hi, let's talk about tuning. Tuning, yeah. There's actually some t-shirts that say tune it or die. And really when you get among other musicians, it is really important to be on tune. It's real frustrating, especially when somebody is performing or you're jamming or something and you find out that you're out and you try to tune in session. If you need to tune, leave. Pick up your dulcimer, move away, and people are going to thank you for it. They might not thank you, but they'll certainly appreciate it. When you come back, you'll be in tune and ready to go. There are a lot of different tuners. I happen to have a pretty nice one here. This is a Seiko, and it has basically a slide. There's two settings on this. One is for manual, which means that I'm tuning based off A. I don't use it. I go over here to the auto, so that any note that it comes up, this will measure it and either tell me sharp, flat, or on. This happens to be an alligator clip. Plugs into the input part here. This alligator clip has a small transducer stuck in it, and you put that onto one of the clips. Some will say clip it to the metal. No, I don't like, or clip it to the wood. I don't like chewing up my wood. So what I do is I place it on a pin, and then I usually push back so that the metal part, it has a wiggle room here, and I'll push it back and so it locks down. If I do that right, when I click a note, this will go ahead and dial in. Now when I'm tuning, some of the tuners, like the Korgs, are really good for a simple little tuner. I usually mount it up here. Take my wrench, little tuning wrench. These fit onto the pins. These fit into the pins that are located over here. So now I can set this pin in here, and I can go over here, and it's kind of important that you follow along which one's which. It kind of allows it to be tuning like crazy and cranking, and the thing's not changing, and all of a sudden the string pops because you're cranking on the wrong one. So I'll go over here and I'll measure, find out which one I'm on. And now you'll notice that I have a side with a pin that I can tune, and then I have another side where the pins are just more or less looped over. Now, when the things are looped over, I'm going to say I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to tune from that side. But I'll go ahead and have the crank up here. Well, let's move it up to here. And now what I'll do is I'll follow this where this crank is, and I'll follow this string until I'm on the right side of the treble bridge. Now, when I'm tuning, I want to make sure that I'm, that sounds bad. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at my dial over here on the tuner. I'm going to bring this up a little bit. I'm going to look at the tune on my dial on my tuner. And it's noticed that if you look at it, it's pretty low. This side's got a little arrow that says it's flat. This is telling me that it's a C, but it's really flat. I'm going to tune this up very slowly as I click it until I'm right on and I get both those lights lighting up. Now when I do that, this is probably going to be sharp. See, it's sharp. There's normal. If I go down to here, that's sharp. Now I'm going to back it off until it's right on. Both lights are lit. You gotta play around with it a little bit. Now that's pretty close. Now I've got that along a little bit flat, so I gotta do it again. Usually I'll tune over a little bit and then back it down. And I'm pretty good there. When you're tuning back and forth, it takes a bit. If you get confused, really confused as to where the note is, you go to another dulcimer or a piano and hit the note that you want to hear. It's pretty good to hear it, then that gets you kind of close. But once you're good on this side, what I'm doing is I'm stretching the whole string out to tune this one. This might be a bit over. I back this out just a little bit, bring that back to the C. Over here, this is a G. I'll click this and then I'll tune it to fine tweak it. So I'm stretching it tight here and then I'm backing it off and they both even out. Now this dulcimer is unique. The last two or three dulcimers I've tuned, if I tune this side falls in. That is very cool. This dulcimer happens to be a little bit cranky on that in that regard. Usually start with either the high and work your way down, low work your way up. Other people tend to tune all the same notes in the dulcimer. There's a lot of theories about how to do it. I've had this dulcimer about 15 years. I've always tuned treble from bottom to top, bass bridge from top down. It hasn't seemed to make a whole lot of difference. Sometimes, now this is maybe a little more weird, this is a very thin wooded dulcimer. What I tend to do is, if I'm going into concert or I want to stay in tune for a while, I'll tune it, and then I'll take my fist and bang it slightly. Sometimes I'll hear a pop. If I hear a pop, then I know, yep, I heard one there. I'm not hitting it hard, but what I'm doing is kind of evening out things. You know, if there's a little more tension on one side than the other, then I'll go back and retune it. Usually by that second tuning, this thing will lock in for a good 3 or 4 hours. And if I'm doing concerts or weddings, I don't have to worry about retuning. That's basic stuff tuning.